It was one of the most anticipated events of the Pope's trip to South Korea. 124 martyrs were declared blessed by Pope Francis as the crowds cheered on. More than 1 million people attended the Mass and beatification of Paul Jun Jing Chung and another 123 martyrs who were killed during the height of the country's religious persecution back in the 18th and 19th century. Catholicism was introduced in the country by the laity. The Pope talked about the martyrs' legacy and their example.
Ci richiamano a mettere Cristo al di sopra di tutto e a vedere tutto il resto in questo mondo in relazione a Lui e al Suo Regno Eterno. Essi ci provocano a domandarci se vi sia qualcosa per cui saremmo disposti a morire.
The Pope also talked about helping the needy by highlighting that the martyrs built small communities where those in need came first.
Il loro esempio ha molto da dire a noi che viviamo in società dove accanto ad immense ricchezze cresce in modo silenzioso la più abietta povertà, dove raramente viene ascoltato il grido dei poveri.
The martyrs lived a life that didn't follow the social structures of the times. Instead, they showed everyone respect by ignoring social standing. The Pope then added that their example of charity and solidarity can still be used today as instruments of peace.
L'eredità dei martiri può ispirare tutti gli uomini e le donne di buona volontà ad operare in armonia per una società più giusta, libera e riconciliata, contribuendo così alla pace e alla difesa dei valori autenticamente umani in questo paese e nel mondo intero.
Towards the end of the ceremony, the Pope also mentioned all the anonymous martyrs who have suffered through persecution because of their faith.